It may well be Sangma versus Sangma in Meghalaya. NPP, the National People's Party, formed by local stalwart Purno Sangma and now led by his son Conrad since his death in 2016, has emerged as the main challenger to Congress Chief Minister Mukul Sangma. Pre-poll defections have often significantly impacted the electoral outcome in the northeastern states. The BJP, for one, has had some success in doing so. As many as 8 sitting MLAs, including 5 from the Congress, joined the NPP in Meghalaya just ahead of elections. Some Congress leaders from the powerful autonomous district councils have also switched to the NPP.
I think an important issue also is really the style and functioning of the Chief Minister. And it is clearly reflected from the fact that a lot of the people from the Congress themselves have left the party. And today have joined other parties, like a lot of them have come to the NPP, some have gone to the BJP, and some have formed their own political party.
In 2017, the NPP emerged as the kingmaker in Manipur, having won 4 seats. It helped the BJP form a government there. In Meghalaya, though a predominantly Christian state, the NPP is aware of some unease over the fact that the party is an NDA ally. The Congress has dubbed the NPP an agent of the BJP. Did that prompt Conrad Sangma's decision to go it alone in these elections?
NPP decided to go on its own. And nobody talks about us not having an alliance with the original parties. But everybody talks about the fact that we don't have an alliance with the BJP. The point is that we simply want to maintain our identity. We want to maintain our ideology. We want to let the people know what the NPP stands for. And the election is a time when we can tell the people who we are, what we are, and what we believe in. And that's the main reason why we are fighting the election on our own. No question of alliance with any political party, for that matter of fact, not just the BJP. And that is how it was even in Manipur. Even in Manipur, we fought the election separately. And only post-election, then scenarios developed and we decided accordingly. So it's nothing to do with any ideology of any party.
But Conrad doesn't rule out a post-poll tie-up with the BJP.
See, post-poll scenario is something that nobody can tell right now. And things will only be clear when the election results are out. So that is the first part of things. Second part of things is that I think this kind of agenda or this idea is sometimes been politicized by the opponents. And I think clearly for us as a political party, we are very clear on our agenda and our ideology. I don't want to comment on anybody else. But I can assure you that NPP will be a party that will stick to its ideologies and will ensure that we work towards maintaining the secular fabric of the nation, and will ensure that we allow people and individuals to practice the religion they want, and also to never will try to influence the eating habits of any individuals. So we are very clear on our agenda. I don't know about other political parties, but we will ensure that we maintain those ideologies and those agendas.